President Obama is preparing to take his second oath of office and working on his domestic agenda for the next 4 years. How about immigration reform? At the top of the list? What exactly does the president hope to accomplish, and is there enough political will to get it done? Dan Stein is the president of the Federation for American Immigration Reform and the former executive director of the Immigration Reform Law Institute. Francisco Hernandez is an immigration law attorney. Welcome to both of you.
Glad to be here.
Good morning.
Nice to have you here. I hate to talk too lawyer-esque for our viewers. We'll break down immigration reform for them if we can. Is it an issue, Fernando, that came up enough so far in the Obama administration?
Well, it's a huge issue because he promised it in the first term and he wasn't able to pass it. But this is an issue that, as a result of the last election, everybody from Long Island to Michigan State, all of my friends on the left and on the right, agree that we have to do something. Just not that long ago, we were passing laws in states that contradicted federal law. So this is the right timing in politics to get this done. I think the momentum is there.
Well, let me then ask you, Dan, this is what you do. This is really the focus of your work. What is the solution?
Well, of course, at FAIR, we want to make sure American families and American citizens get a fair shake in the labor market and equal opportunity. We think this administration has undermined any prospect for meaningful legislative action because they've unilaterally abandoned immigration law enforcement. And when you tell the American people, look, we're just not going to enforce the laws, when you sue the states and say, we don't really want you to try to force us or even get your assistance in helping enforce these laws, then you're telling the American people that so-called reform in Congress is nothing but a big amnesty program with absolutely no prospect of meaningful immigration enforcement in the future. So it basically, everything the Obama administration has done and people like Senator Durbin have done for the last 4 years has actually undermined any pressure for true legislative action and true immigration policy. When we've talked about piecemeal reforms, like Marco Rubio wanted to, you know, we're talking about an e-verify bill to make sure American workers get, you know, the jobs that are available. The president opposed that. They talked about a STEM package for high-tech visas. Not that we supported that, but still, the president says, you know, all that stuff is so popular, we want to attach an unpopular, massive amnesty program that nobody really wants or needs in exchange for getting anything that really would be needed.
Let me let you weigh in here, Francisco, but I want to ask you have dual citizenship, from what I understand, with the United States and Mexico. So do you...
Yes.
Why, Dan? That's so surprising. I saw the reaction on your face. But, Francisco, do you come at this from a different perspective than having lived in both countries and making your living here in this country? And tell me, as someone who came to this country and made your life here, what you think the solution is and where is the money going to come from, given everything else that we have to spend in this nation?
Sure. Well, let's look at it from a different perspective. Let's call them what they really are, potential tax contributors. I was actually born in the United States, but I have five brothers and sisters, and half of us were born in Mexico, half of us were born here. My children have three nationalities. Their mother's Dutch, so they're Dutch citizens. You know, but let's not talk about what we disagree on. Let's just go on what we agree on. Work permits. My side is going to have to give up on automatic citizenship or automatic path to citizenship. I'm with you, Mr. Stein. You have some really good ideas. But let's go back to what we agree on. Work permits. Let's find out who these folks are so they can get driver's licenses and get insurance so when they hit our cars, we can get paid for our damages. They can work and earn wages and pay towards Social Security. Do the math.
But Dan, are we going to keep talking about this or are we actually going to be able to get it done? What political capital does the president have left and will he have to act on his own or do you think he can generate the bipartisan support that he would need to get something passed?
Well, look, the president has approached this issue in a very divisive way. He talked about our enemies when he talked to the Latino community before the election, suggesting that Americans who want our borders were enforced or our immigration laws enforced were somehow anti-Latino. He turned around and did this illegal Dream Act amnesty by executive action after 3.5 years of saying he did not have the power under the law or the Constitution.
Mr. Stein, you know it's
and then
not.
He turned around and bludgeoned the Republicans and tried to drive this wedge between Latino voters and the Republican Party by somehow suggesting that immigration controls were anti-Latino. Now, to turn around and then say, oh, we're all going to sing Kumbaya and pass a big amnesty bill when the administration says they don't even care about future law enforcement means that there's simply no basis for meaningful legislative action.
I'm up against
No one has to do an amnesty, Mr. Stein. Let's just pass on what we agree on. Let's stop throwing rocks. Let's just
work together. Well, let's agree on E-Verify. E-Verify, everybody agrees on E-Verify.
I'm up against a hard break, but I like the idea of at least getting something started, something that everybody can agree on. Thank you so much for your thoughts today. Appreciate your time.
Thank you.